What's up, guys? Welcome back to the TenorShare channel. When you update your iPhone or iPad using iTunes on a computer, you might get the attempting data recovery screen when the process is done. If things go smoothly, you can return to the home screen with everything staying intact. If not, you might get stuck here or get into an endless loop. In this video, we'll show you three methods to fix it. Let's get started. No computer around, not a problem. You can give your phone a force restart. For iPhone 8 or later, press and quickly release the volume up and down buttons successively, then press and hold the side button. Let it go when you see the Apple logo. After a reboot, it may start working. If it doesn't, fret not. You can try to fix it with ReiBoot on a computer. Once connected your phone, click Start on the home screen and proceed with the standard repair so you won't lose any data. To get it recognized without entering the passcode, follow the guide here to put your phone into recovery mode. For iPhone 8 or later, after quickly pressing and releasing the volume up and down button, press and hold the side button until you see the recovery mode screen. ReiBoot prepares the firmware. Once downloaded, you can start repairing. After the repair is completed, you might get through the recovery process smoothly. And of course, you'll find all your data intact once you get to the home screen. Moving on to our last part, you can restore your phone to factory settings in iTunes, then get your data back from your backup. So only do this when you are confident that you have backed up your device before, then make sure to put it into recovery mode and proceed with the restore option. After getting you the firmware, iTunes will go on to erase your device. To get your data from the backup is not difficult, just a bit time-consuming if you got a big data size. Let's take iCloud for example. All you have to do is choose a backup that might contain most of your data, then proceed with a few customizable settings until you see the progress bar. Once done, your apps and files will be loading from iCloud. So that's it. Thanks for watching. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to share it with your friends. See you.